Jimmy continues on to the hotel where he registers as Ralph D. Spencer. In a conversation with the hotel keeper, Jimmy learns that Elmore does not have a shoe store and that business is good in the town. Jimmy Valentine does not rob the bank. Instead, Ralph Spencer settles in Elmore, opens a profitable shoe store, becomes a social success, and makes the acquaintance of Adam Unavail. Jimmy enjoys great success. His business is growing day by day. He and Unavail soon to be married, and Unavail's father and sister accepted him. Jimmy completely cut with his past. He writes a letter to his friend. He also writes one of his friend and asking him to meet him in Little Rock because he planned to give him the set of safe cracking tools to him. Then the band. Then when Price arrives in Elmore and collects the information, he came to know he got married with Annabelle Adams. Next day, Jimmy goes to the bank. Jimmy goes to the bank with his tools suitcase. Mrs. Annabelle, Annabelle's sisters with her two daughters, May and Agatha, also came there. There was a new safe with funny clock and knobs. Okay? There was a new safe with funny clock and knobs. Meanwhile, Ben Price came into the bank and watches the scene. Without warning, then May playfully locks Agatha in the bank vault. Now, Mr. Adams tries to open the vault, but it can't be opened. Agatha's mother was very worried for her. Mr. Adams exclaimed in horror, since the time and the combination had not been set. So all were very worried. Then Annabel Adams requested to Jimmy, please do something. He smiles and opens his suitcase and took out some tools. Then he breaks the vault's lock. And Agatha soon came out of the vault and ran to her mother. Now she was safe. So as he means Jimmy Valentine came out the bank, Ben Price arrested him in the case of vulgarity. This is the end of the story. So, okay, students.